In this video, we're going to talk about auxiliary mixes and how to use them for the most common application, monitor mixing. Because I don't want to have to keep saying auxiliary mix for this whole video, let's call them auxes, like everybody else does. Before we talk about how to use auxes, let's talk about what an aux is.
As a signal enters the TouchMix via its input, it passes through the channel's processing chain, the delay, equalizer, and dynamics, before going to the channel fader, pan control, and finally to the main output. An aux lets us take signal from a point in the processing chain. We call that the pickoff point, and use it to create another mix that is sent to a separate aux output. A TouchMix mixer gives you options for where in the processing chain the signal comes from. To access and change these pickoff points, select your aux mix on the side of the screen. Now press the aux name above the main output fader to access the output processing for that aux. Press Setup at the top of the screen. You'll see the different pickoff options here. Pre-all means the aux signal has not passed through any channel processing. In other words, it is picked off right at the point where it enters the channel. Pre-dynamics means the signal has been processed by the channel EQ, but not by the gate and compressor. Post-fader means that the signal going to the aux has passed through all the channel processing and the channel fader. When the channel fader is raised or lowered, the signal going to the aux will change as well. Pre-fader means that the signal has passed through all the channel processing, but won't be affected by the channel fader. This is the default setting in TouchMix and is most commonly used for monitors, which brings us to the next part of this video.
The most common use of an auxiliary mix is to set up a monitor mix for performers. This is typically sent to a monitor wedge on stage or in your monitor system. There are two approaches to working with performers to build monitor mixes. Mix on faders, working with each performer one at a time to set up a complete mix, and send from channels, working with one input channel at a time to give all the performers the desired amount of each instrument or input. Neither of these methods is better than the other, but most engineers find that one or the other feels more natural and better fits their workflow.
Singer, what do you want your
this approach is no different from setting up your main house mix, except that your audience is smaller, just the performer who is hearing the mix.
Any guitar?
No.
To work on a mix for a performer, select the aux mix that feeds their monitor using the tabs on the left side of the screen. Note that we've named our auxes so we can easily find the right one. Now, the faders on the screen are the faders that control the selected aux mix. Experienced performers will know what they want to hear. Some kick drum, snare and hat, a little bass, some keys, and a lot of vocals. After they run a song during soundcheck, this will need adjustment.
The other approach is to send from channels. Send from channels will probably work better when you're working with performers who aren't sure what they want to hear. With this approach, we can get rough mixes for everyone and then switch to mix on faders for fine tuning.
To send from channels, go into your first input channel and select either the Overview tab or the Auxes tab. Ask the performer whose voice or instrument is feeding the channel to do their thing for a few seconds, then ask each performer how much of that instrument or voice they want to hear in their monitor.
All right, guys, who needs snare?
Once you've dialed that up for each performer, move on to another channel and repeat the process.
Guitar.
What if you want to work with all the aux mixes at once? Just push the aux button on your mixer and you'll see the aux overview, a matrix of mini sliders for all the aux mixes on the console. Touch any slider and use the mixer's rotary knob or the app's up-down buttons to adjust.
Now each musician can hear only the instruments they want to hear at precisely the level that suits their needs. And this won't affect the mix that the audience hears. With the abundance of aux outputs on the TouchMix, every band member can create their own personal monitor mix. What's more, is that with the Wi-Fi capabilities, each band member can control their monitor mix right from their smartphone or tablet.
Keys, what do you need?
No, I'm good. Just let me take the guitar down a little bit.
One last thing. Performers will usually not play at performance levels when you're doing the sound check. Playing in front of a crowd is a lot more exciting than playing during sound check. Plus, a performer's hearing becomes less sensitive as the performance goes on, which means that stage volume will increase during the show. So the vocal wedge that was just killing the lead singer during soundcheck, well, after the third song, he can't even hear it. Make sure your monitor rig has plenty of output and gain before feedback. But that's another video. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for the next video.